Good morning, dear students. Today on our second lecture in April, second lecture meetings, I see only six participants. And my suggestion is to wait a few minutes for newcomers, because the better to start a little bit later. Okay, let's wait a few minutes and after it we will start.
Okay.
About how to divide the material, our today's material. But I think we have two parts of our today's lecture with only one break. It will be enough. It will be hard for you to catch the ideas, to catch the material from me and my colleagues. Well, as for our today's topics, not topic, but topics, I've decided to take two rather short topics. One of them, this is platforms and traditional companies. The another one, this is prospects of platform in different industries. Why? As for these topics, they are so short, because this is, I think, like base for seminars, because it will be really hard to avoid examples, and I think it will be right if you will construct, you will find information for you exactly for your platforms when you will prepare analysis. But in any case, I'm trying to give you some tools, some checklists, how to do it. Maybe we will discuss some examples from some spheres. I'm not sure. Maybe it will be right to take examples not exactly from spheres of your platform, because we need to be honest. We need to. We needn't give a possibility to prepare task in easy aid for any teams, because all teams are equal. And but in any case, you will need to analyze traditional companies, relations between traditional companies and your platform, and maybe other platforms or from your industry, and to think about prospects of platforms in your industry. Well, in industry of your platform, so I'm starting to demonstrate my presentation. Do you see it?
Yes, we do.
But I don't see my presentation.
No, I can't see it.
Okay.
Now we can see it.
Well, as for platforms and traditional companies, just one moment. This is, I think, if we will say about the age of digital transformation, about processes of this age, about nowadays time, current time, this is the main battle, not only battle, but partnership, but any other ways how to cooperate or how to fight between two main players, traditional companies and platforms. As for Our agenda for this topic, because I already said that we have two topics, platforms and traditional companies. This is the main topic for today's meeting. And another topic, rather short, about prospects of using platforms, or prospects of platforms in different industries. What are the points? Power of platforms, checklist for traditional companies, and strategic responses. As for the first part, power of platforms, during our lectures, our meetings, not only lectures, but seminars too, we try to analyze, to understand the essence of platform from the view of platforms and their customers. I think it would be right to identify it in this way. Customers or users, because you remember that we have different type of participants of platforms. But as for today's topic, this is something that you from their competitors, main competitors, you from traditional companies, how to understand about threats, how to understand threats from platforms, what are the possibilities for development for traditional companies from platforms, in platforms cooperation, and what are the possible steps for realizing advantages and eliminating risks of platforms. Power of platforms, and as I already said, we try to see on platforms from companies, traditional companies view. Some statements at the beginning, platforms as disruptors. The first, which is platforms enable direct cooperation between asset owners, and asset providers. By doing so, we disrupt traditional business models and destroy the image of value created by traditional companies. About creation of value, about platform business models, we said in our previous meetings. But not only creation of value, delivery of value, and capture of value for platforms users, but about destroying the image of value by tradition, image of value of traditional companies. We can also use this statement when we try to describe, to analyze current situation on the markets. And platforms are a major threat for traditional businesses that are now losing their profits and being bankrupt. I think from one side, if we will try to see on platforms as disruptors, yes, it's true, because let's take an example, easy example of one of platforms from my seminars groups, Yandex Taxi. I think 5, maybe 7 years ago, as for market of taxi services, it was absolutely another market with another rules, another main players, and after coming platforms, such platforms like Uber and Yandex Taxi, we can say about dramatic changes on this market, and dramatic changes not only for traditional companies, but for changes in market structure. Because we've gotten new players, strong players, and they now they're putting rules for function for such marking. And yes, we will, I think, during today's lectures, we will repeat this phrase maybe many times, that possible existing, possible coming of platforms for traditional companies market. This is one of the main threat for such market, and companies must be ready for it, must understand how to fight, or maybe how to cooperate with such players. Or maybe companies will create their own platforms. This is another way, and we will say about it in part of, about strategic responses. Another way to create their own platforms for making their business wider, for expanding competition. But let's move to the power of platforms. The first entry point. Platforms may enter any segment of the market as assets owned by individual sites, extremely diverse, and may use by various groups of customers. It means that platforms may frequent traditional companies from all segments. I already started to say about it. If you are a traditional company, during our lectures, if I remember right, I used that if you are a platform, you can characterize any specific features and such. But as for our today's topics, if you are a traditional company, yes, possible possibility of opportunity of coming of entrance of platform on your market, strong platform. This is, I think, the highest risk nowadays. And why? Because we will continue to say about it for next points of the power of platforms. But the first, that it's rather easy for platforms to enter such markets if they have suitable conditions. And yes, as for entry point, case of entry point, this is another one more table for it, just for explaining essence of platforms entering the market. The first, many make, many sell. This is the essence of platforms, and this is the reason why at the beginning, at the first steps of their existence, the first steps of entering the market, they have so strong competitive advantage. Because if you will say software company, it will take software company, make one, sell many. It's closer to platform structure, but only from one side. As for service provider,
excuse me.
Yes, sir.
In the example of a software company, maybe make one but buy many. So, in the case of the word sell, I don't understand the structure. So, does that mean that?
Produce one product,
mm-hmm.
software product, and we can sell this product to a lot of customers. But we needn't to make a lot of copies of this product because this information haven't problems with it.
Okay.
Because if we will take, for example, a service provider, if we will have only one barber, he will work only with one customers in just exact period of time. And as for product company, you produce one product and you sell one product. You can copy. You need external facilities, sorry, additional facilities for copying it and for selling. This
Okay.
is the essence of platforms. Well, as for grow rate after entering to the market, why the platforms has very, very high rate of growth? The first, this is thanks to network effects. Platforms are growing very fast, and I think any sphere, any industry, it will take, for example, transport and delivery, financial services, or maybe products and goods, or labor services. If we will develop a platform, the main story is to create a critical mass of users, and you need them to create strong, build big physical assets, or maybe to hire new workers for expanding. You need just to work with already existing potential users, potential participants of your platform, and to invite, to make them to join your platform. To explain them why it will be more useful, more valuable, much potential users to enter this platform. And another story that such, how to say, already this part of users who already used your platform will be a strong and right instrument for developing for inviting such potential users for their being of participants of platforms. Even many potential platforms do not survive, it's true. We also have different examples in different spheres with unsuccessful platforms, but those that do increase their size at an extremely high rate, the winners take it all, take the market, and I think as for this part of our lecture, I like example from transport and delivery sector, from taxi services. Yes, we've got new players, new platforms a few years ago, and I think maybe you remember this period, maybe not, period of struggle, competition between traditional companies, traditional taxi services, and platforms, which Uber or Yandex Taxi. But I think the main story, the main competitive advantage was the size, was the possibilities of services possibilities of providing service from platforms. They had more possibilities than usual taxi services. Yes, we also have some disadvantages, because we will say about platforms for taxi market. This is the case when this is the case of market, because sometimes drivers can don't want drivers don't want to take any orders, and it becomes the problem of such platforms. And as for such, I think rather unique situations. This is the time for traditional taxi services with their facilities, their possibilities, their drivers to take such orders. But as for such orders, they are not. How to say? They haven't mass character. And yes, this is another picture for demonstrating this story about railway. Why platform business model, platform business has more possibilities for development. And the answer is cost. I already the answer is decreasing costs. I already said about it in case of taxi services market, because if for traditional company, if you need to cover more clients, more potential clients, you need to buy and to use more physical assets, if, for example, to take traditional taxi services. As for platforms, this is another story. We need just new drivers with their own cars for covering wider market, wider part of market. And this is example, the essence of such part of power of platforms like growth. Easy change, another story. And this is also, we can return to example from taxi services. Platforms can easily switch to new segments within the market. I don't know what about Uber in other seminars group, as I already said in my seminars group, as for transport and delivery, we have an example of Yandex Taxi. But as for Uber, started as high-end service, but later it launched low-price service, and this is true for different spheres. As example, if we can take, if we will move to financial platforms, two-sided financial platforms, we also can see different ways of development, because at the beginning, as for all crowd financing services, crowd financing platforms, where essence was crowdfunding, just collecting money for non-commercial, for social projects. But after some changes, after first steps in development, we can say about crowd lending. This is more commercial story for development of financial platforms, and crowd investing. This is absolutely high level of development, because this is something like the picture of crowd financial market. Because you have a possibility to become an owner, or maybe a participant of any project or financing project or company. And if you take other spheres, this is the same situation. I think You also remember case from goods and services from Avito. The first story was that where development was only for small part of products when you want to buy to buy something not new, already used, but in good conditions. But after a few years of development, Avito has strong direction of development in real estate, in retail, sorry, not retail, but in online shopping and other spheres. As for labor services, I think, and as for labor services and other industries, I think we can say about the same situation. It's really easy for platforms, and this is one of them, I think the main point of our power, to change, to develop on new segments and even new industries. And this is the real problem for traditional companies, because if, for example, we will take the case of Uber to return to this case, I think traditional taxi services hadn't strong worries about existing, about coming of this service, this platform, because it was high-end service. But later, after a few years of development, Uber became a strong competitor for all taxi services through all, I think, the biggest part of countries, world countries. And this is, as I already said, it's very important for companies, for traditional companies, to identify, this will be the second part about checklist for traditional companies, to identify in the right way opportunities for entering such platforms on their market. And maybe the answer is it's possible to develop their own platforms, or maybe to create conditions to create barriers with other competitors for entering such platforms. I think we already said about the case of Uber and their problems with law regulation in Britain, in USA too. And I think this is the example of such lobby from side of traditional taxi services. In other industries, I think we can face with the same attempts as for our country, Yandex Taxi, also faced with such barriers. But we can't say that these barriers stopped development of such services. Maybe if we will say about it will be something like a story of financial sector about ICO case, because different countries create special laws for blocking potential ICOs, and it was the answer. But I'm not sure that it was the answer from traditional financial sector. But I'm not sure that it's possible in other case of, especially case of platforms. If we will take platforms, if we will take ICO, to my opinion, it's not a classical platform. It's a little bit other financial instrument, but also it's digital financial instruments for development in financial sector. And yes, as I already said, we can move. It's very important for traditional companies, especially traditional companies, to identify risks, to identify pain points, to identify opportunities for coming platforms on their market. And as for next part, second part, this topic, we prepared this list of questions with Ivan Kotlerov some couple of years ago, but I think it's how to say, it's not useless right now. Well, as for checklist for traditional companies, the first question is: distant intermediation of assets possible within the given industry? Yes, it needs to understand that not for all, absolutely all industries it's possible entering of platforms, creating of platforms, because in some spheres, and we will say about it a little bit later today, it's not, the conditions are not so suitable for developing platforms. Maybe sometimes this is a question of technological development, level of technological development, because creating new technologies or developing already existing, especially digital technologies, will give a possibility to create platforms on such markets. But right now we can say that for some industries, for some spheres, it's not so strong risk, risk of entering platform for the market. Are there underused assets owned by individuals that can be put and offered to a platform? This is continuation, second question, this is continuation describing the assets, sorry, describing the conditions, suitable conditions for entering, for creating platform on companies' markets. And this case about assets, about understanding, sorry, understanding about underused assets, the existing companies' markets. And as for traditional companies, yes, it needs to it needs to understand about it needs to have understanding about such underused assets on their market. Are there already any platforms on the market? If so, what segments we are targeting? This is returning to the case of Uber and this first point, right, high-end service. I think, yes, as for traditional companies, you need to worry if you take traditional companies' view, if you have understanding that you see functioning of platforms in other segments of your company's markets. Maybe we can move to another example of hotels and platforms in this sphere, like such platforms like Airbnb, as example. Yes, as for the starting point of this platform, it was just a possibility to organize platform, to organize service for founding apartments. But right now We can say about development in different spheres and even traditional companies, traditional hotels, they need to cooperate, to be a partner with such platforms, because this is a possibility for them to develop their business, to attract more customers. Is the growth rate of existing platform high? It's, I think, one of the hardest questions, because when we say about development of platforms, I already said about, for example, Yandex Taxi and development of platforms in other sphere. A few years ago, I think, not so long period of time, we didn't know anything for the biggest part of us. We didn't know anything about a lot of platforms, but just a couple, 2 or 3, maybe 4 years ago, it was the first the first stage of this platform's evolution, when we started to say about it, we started to describe, and the speed of development in different industries, it's really different, because I think we can say about rather old platforms, old services in different industries, but we also can describe development and creating and development of rather new companies. As for all services, like an example, we knew about Uber, about options, opportunities of such services, but development from Yandex, development with segments from Yandex and cooperation with Uber create absolutely giant player on this market and totally transformed rules and conditions of this market. It's really hard to calculate, to define the growth rate, but it must to do for traditional companies. Maybe it will be a possibility to create their own platform business and to develop it like a strategic response for such risks. Story is the total market share of platforms becoming high. I think when I prepared this lecture, I tried to collect to analyze some articles, and I think if you want to find information about platforms, one of the most popular title of article, this is what, 7 of 10, 7 from 10 biggest world biggest companies used or using or becoming a platform in their business model. And now it's as for a lot of services, a lot of sectors, we have such risks, and like a second step from second step from identifying growth rate, this is identifying total market share of platforms, and to analyze the numbers about development. Do platforms try to enter new segments of the market? This is, we can return to the example of Uber. Yes, if these services, such platforms, such services, try to enter new segments, it seems non-usual segments for for such companies, this is a bad signal for traditional companies, because it means that you've got strong competitors, strong platform competitor who will development, who will try to take the whole market, to expand, to make their market share wider. New platforms try to go beyond the primary market. This is something that part of the previous question, because not only new segments of already existing market, but attempts to develop in new markets. And as for this story, we can take example of Yandex company, which developed cloud of services, not only transport, but delivery too. And they try to organize one big services in case of transport sphere. And this is also a bad signal for traditional companies in these spheres, because we don't know what will be the next step of such platform. Especially we'll say about, for example, Yandex company, maybe you already heard this news, but they will develop their own financial services, Yandex banking, and we also saved the name Yabank, if I'm right, for developing it. And it means that such players like traditional banks, they need to wait, and they need to understand how to work with this potential new player on the financial market, on the market of financial services. And when you will prepare your analysis, maybe it will be the right decision. You can try to suggest new ways for development of your for your platforms. I think, and to explain why, I think our next topic for today, prospects of platforms development in this industry, and as for this topic, it's also true that you can it will help you to understand what are the possible ways of developing platforms. Yes. Have you any questions about this one?
So, in general, a platform company is a big threat to traditional companies.
In the biggest part of cases, because as we can understand from this part of lecture, it's really easy for platforms to enter new market and to develop, especially if we can identify suitable conditions for it. But it's not true for all industries. And it's as for our next material for today, we will try to understand what are the possible strategic responses for from companies. And I remember that we also will say about, we'll discuss about creating crowd lending platforms, as example, from banks, as an answer for coming platforms. But yes, due to the reason of technological development and Other competitive advantage of platform business, other competitive advantages of platform business models, we can say about expanding spheres for platforms entering. This is the summary.
Okay.
So what? Thank you. What about other questions? What is the situation with the time? Well, I think you have it will be right to give you a possibility to think about the questions. Sorry, but do you see my presentation?
We can see your screen, and now we can see Teams, and when you.
I don't see the red line, which means that.
We can see your screen, and presentation now too.
Okay. Well, in any case, now this is a time for break. It will be 30 minutes, like it's my usual life, one big break. And after 30 minutes, I will continue. Thank you for your attention. Yes.
So, at what time will you start?
12:35.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Okay. You are welcome. Well, 30 minutes break. Thank you.